So we are from the Excel Sheesh Assessment X Block team, and they are my group mates Agnivesh and Shreya. Before going to our objective, just imagine a scenario in which there is one accounting teacher and thousands of students are enrolled in his course. So after the examination, just imagine the situation when he has to check all the thousands copies of that student. It is somewhat a more hectic process for him, right? So our X block comes into the scenario in this situation. Our objective is to build an X block which can auto-grade Excel sheets. So, and the purpose, our main purpose is to simplify the checking of balance sheets in accounting questions. And we are auto-grading the sheets by just comparing the cells of the Excel sheets. So it can be extended to any type of questions which involve cell comparisons of Excel sheets, which is having text data, not music or anything else like videos. So the scope is the future of the platform is means many students can enroll in the course. So we have configured our storage to two types, like Unix and S3, and we are doing the automatic grading. And exporting the grades, we are also exporting the grades to OpenEdX platform, which teachers also can see. So moving to the demonstration.
Before we start our demonstration, I would just like to tell you how the Excel sheets should look like how the teacher should make the Excel sheets. Now say the teacher wants a student to fill answers in this particular cell. So what he will do is, he will fill this cell with the marks for that particular question and enclose it with angular brackets. By doing this, when the student will open and see it, the student will understand that he has to fill answers in this particular cell. For example, in the previous slide, in this particular cell, 20 was enclosed in angular brackets. So in this slide, in the file that will be uploaded by the student will fill 30,000, which is the answer in this particular cell. Now moving on with the demonstration.
Okay, these bracket 20 are the marks.
Yes.
For that particular cell.
Like the teacher has mentioned it in the instructions that the cells in which a particular number is enclosed within angular brackets, the student will have to remove all the contents of that particular cell and fill in his answer. Yeah.
No,
he has to replace the angular brackets, and in the empty cell he has to fill in his answer.
That
yeah,
is the marks.
Is the marks.
Is the corresponding marks for that cell. So should we show the teacher's perspective or just the student?
So if you want, we can show from the beginning only.
No. Don't show from the beginning. We want the time for
the. Do you want to see the teacher's view? Then we can show you the teacher's view, like how the teacher fills in the answers and everything.
Why the teacher will see anything?
No, like.
There is no teacher's view, correct?
Sir, there is teacher's view because
view.
He will uploading the question.
Uploading the question, that's okay.
Yeah.
That's okay. So uploading the question is just one Excel sheet.
Yeah, two with that he can put a.
For you, okay. How does the teacher upload the answer to you?
Yes, sir. Like in the teacher's view, he has to upload two files.
This is what the teacher uploads.
Yeah, this is the question paper.
This is on the floor.
So this is the question. Right over here, and this is the place where the student answers the file.
And the teacher also uploads the solution view for the correct answers.
They are only looking at that bracket. Where is the answer sheet?
These are the two files that the teacher uploads.
We just compare.
Yeah.
No, sir, like the for the comparison, only
so
those.
Comparison. Yeah. Am I right? Somewhere?
It only considers the angular bracket fields.
Question
and solution file.
The correct solution.
And the solution file.
Yeah.
Why they should be two different things?
Sir, because.
So that's up to the teacher.
That's supposed to be the teacher's
work. Sir, like how can we know the correct answer? Like the teacher should know the correct answers.
No, but as he said, the teacher by mistake removes one line, so you know that he has filled the wrong answer, no?
Sir, while checking the question, means answer sheet of the student, teacher knows na, that what is the correct
teacher
answer.
Teacher is not checking the answer sheet of the student, you are checking.
Yeah, but I am considering the general process. I am considering the general process, what is happening.
So forget the general process, I am just asking you a question that if a teacher has made a mistake in giving you the answer sheet.
Sir, but that is teacher's mistake.
But you are supposed to catch it? Teacher's mistake hai ne kya? You are going to punish the student for teacher's mistake.
So teacher have to again upload his question file.
But how will he know that he has made a mistake?
Sir, like we can't know the answers, right? So how will we know the answers?
Of course you know what the answer is. You know what the answer is. And you are lazy.
Sir, suppose...
See, I expect people to think. And you are still not thinking.
Sir, suppose a question file is uploaded. So
and answer file is uploaded, correct?
Answer file is uploaded. So what the teacher is uploading a question file, how the system will knows the what is the corresponding right answer file for that particular question file? How this our system
tell
is
tell me.
The system ko kaise pata chalega
ki teacher ne galti. Tell me, that is the question I am asking.
There is no way to know it.
Of course there is a way to know it.
For that we should have all the question, all the answer files of all type of questions in the world.
Why? Only these type of
sir,
question
sir, because, no.
Bracket 10 and
yeah.
5 you said.
Yeah.
Uska answer barabar hai ki nahi? Teacher has supplied answer to that, no.
Yeah.
He is not giving all questions and all files and you match. ऐसा कुछ नहीं ना
नहीं नहीं
हाँ ही इज गिविंग वन क्वेश्चन एक्सेल शीट एंड आंसर शीट फॉर दैट एक्सेल एंड यू आर टेलिंग मी यू डोंट नो हाउ टू वेदर दैट आंसर शीट इज करेक्ट और नॉट बट स्टिल यू आर एबल टू ग्रेड हंड्रेड्स ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स
सर बेसिक
वी आर रिज्यूमिंग दैट दैट आंसर शीट इज करेक्ट
बट यू कांट चेक वेदर दैट आंसर शीट इज करेक्ट
checking on the basis of what?
So like different things can happen in this particular balance sheet, like this is quite predictable. Say under non-current assets, if the teacher fills in like all the options and then like in that particular case, inside some like for some cells, the answer will be blank, right? So if the teacher by mistake leaves the cell blank, then there is no way to know whether he has
this
done
very
it correctly
interesting.
Or not.
So basically, you are not even checking whether all the bracket 20 okay, in the answer I have been supplied. Why are you not checking that?
Sir, because in certain cases the cells can be blank.
There are bracket 20 in the answer file. There are only the sample solutions.
Correct. Yeah. But come on. The bracket 10, take 10. Yeah. Those are the only cells you are going to check.
Yeah. Yes.
All other cells you are ignoring that you answered him.
Yeah.
Correct? Huh. Correct? Huh. Now those cells you can't even check whether teacher answer has got the those cells filled.
But the answer could be a blank. The answer could be a blank. For example, let's consider this question itself.
What do you do with the student?
The student has to submit a blank too. Either a blank or a zero.
What do you do with that?
So for example, agar, let's say there are only premises, furniture and vehicles written over here. The student can clearly understand that he has to...
No, it's okay. We will leave that's a... minor thing, that is not correct at all. Okay.
So that the student does not directly get.
Because you added this new complication that the answer can be blank. Okay.
Solution will also be blank.
Solution is blank. Correct.
You can just copy.
All the cells you can compare. Question and answer sheet, the cells you can compare. And then both have matching. Then it is okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Basically,
file the position of the,
yeah, because we are just
actually the problem is again I am saying that the problem is laziness, okay, but I am sure the problem is laziness because there is no reason, okay, for the teacher to supply two things, okay, there is absolutely no reason. You are adding the complication. I understand. No, forget your inventory. I am not worried about accounting. I am not worried about anything. I am talking about Excel sheet, which says, okay, again, as I talked to you about that other fellow, chess fellow, it is only a block. So you are talking about Excel sheet, which has got certain cells, okay, which have got, which are supposed to have bracket, some number bracket. That number is treated by you as the marks for those cell. Okay. Now, you are saying that the correct answer for that cell, okay, is to be submitted somewhere else. Why it can't be submitted in the same thing?
Because so, this will be shown to the student.
Correct. That's why I said laziness. Okay. Why can't you generate what is to be shown to the student?
So how will we know if that cell is a part of the question or part of the solution?
Because your thing is that bracket 10 bracket, then I am supposed to give an answer. Yes. It can be blank. Okay, so remove that and then show it to the student. No,
sir, how
you can't. You are writing software. No, so in this particular case, I will write bracket 10 bracket 30,000. You remove 30,000 and give it to the student.
Sir, then the student won't know for which cell he gets how much.
Bracket 10 you keep. What I am saying is, in the same cell, in the whatever answer, whatever you are asking the teacher to give, okay, you are asking him to give two things in the cell. You can put bracket, 10, bracket, question mark, dalo kuch bhi, it is your business, so you are specifying, okay. So you can say in the same cell, you have to give the marks and you give the answer. I will remove the answer and give it to the student.
Yeah,
as simple as that. Then my problem is solved. Okay.
Yes.
So you can't ask him to give two things and if there is a mismatch, all 100 students are wrong and then I have to do a repeat. Are you allowing a repeat? Good.
Yeah.
Regrading.
Regrading. The teacher can set a number of re-attempts you can take.
At attempts, nahi, regrading. I made a mistake. All my students have got zero. I made a mistake. I will give a second model answer. Are you allowing that?
He can re-upload the question and answer file.
Are student have already answered, no?
No, that won't be allowed.
Correct. Re-evaluation. My model, aajkal IIT bhi kar raha hai. Question number 4 questions are wrong, 18 mark de do. Mujhe mark nahi dena hai, mujhe re-correct karunga na main. Regrade. You're not allowing regrade.
No.
Because of a mistake I have made in answer submission, so you should have done that, but that's okay. It's good, I like it. Okay.
So we are allowing the teacher to test his uploads first before he publishes it to the students.
How
will I test?
Sir, he can again download his question file what he has uploaded and then he can publish.
Nani?
Sir, in the ideal scenario, if somebody submits the ideal answer file, he should be getting a full mark.
Are correct, but that is what I was trying to ask you, that you can check that whether the answer is correct by submitting the teacher, re-evaluating the teacher ka answer. Okay, but you'll always get 100 even if I made a mistake. Okay, my problem was answer sheet mein main mistake karunga. I make one column up and route, so that doesn't solve me because you are allowing blank.
Yes.
Okay, so I got a problem. That's why I said you should have question and answer correct, but that's okay. Fine. And finally, you are giving one answer to these guys.
Student gets to have a set number of attempts at this question. One of the parameters.
No, that is fine. That is fine. So good. I think you have completed what you set out to do. One problem only in the requirement. That's okay. Fine.
This is fixable within like 2 hours.
Yeah. I think you should do that. Okay. Don't take two files. Take only one file.
Okay.
Okay? And yes. If you are doing bracket, bracket and question mark, whatever two things, hash, whatever you want to do, answer will be within that. Okay, remove that hash portion and then give the answer sheet to the student. Okay, that's it.
Okay.
Basically, you take the answer sheet and generate the question paper yourself. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So that would be best. Okay, if you can do that, I think we can configure anything.
I don't know whether it will work out. So you know, generally we write formulas.
Yes.
Yeah. So that is covered.
Rather than numbers,
yeah.
The place where if I change one number somewhere, you know, the whole thing reflects in the Excel sheet.
Yeah.
So is it covered?
It is covered.
Sir, because we are taking.
So instead of 30,000, I write equal to that cell,
yeah.
You will mark it,
yes,
correct.
Sir.
How do we address
addressing formula?
Two files. That is why it is. You have two files.
Yeah.
Suppose you have one single file.
Okay.
And the solution that he has given you separated by marks, comma. How do you address that?
Huh? how will I address that? In the cell, we can have the max within quotation, and we can have a comma. After that, we can have the solution.
We can have a formula for a cell.
For a formula for a cell. The teacher uploads a formula. That can't be done in the method he suggested.
Sir, we can provide a dictionary type question. One place will be a hash table like. One will be indexing will be done through formula, and then the corresponding values will be his answers.
So, for example, if a student answer with the dynamic balance, so instead of that 49,000, yes. I write a formula equal to sum of that those three. You will mark me correct.
Yeah. Presently, we mark that correct. Like in the method.
You have to mark me correct.
Yeah.
The answer is 49,000.
Yeah.
You don't expect me to use a calculator.
No.
I can use Excel formula.
Yeah. Sure.
Okay, and it will still be correct.
Yeah.
The answer should be correct. In any ways you.
Excel formula.
Yeah.
So that 30,000 can be equal to that cell.
Yeah.
It will still be marked correct.
Yeah. Sure. So if the teacher wants to upload a formula for a cell, that can be done in the method you suggested.
No, I don't want to upload any formula.
Okay. So that's
perfect. Not at present. Okay. I think that's fine. There are other ways to do it, but that's okay.
Cool. Sir, for scalability purpose,
so
we have.
You are going to give it to IIM Bangalore? It is much simpler. Should work.
So do we go?
There are other ways to do it, because and you will faithfully retain all the teachers thing of that, right? Read protection and write protection, only these cells are visible and all that business.
Yes sir.
If I do it properly.
Yes sir.
Okay. You will faithfully work with it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. So when a teacher uploads something which does not need that all that stupid bracket, everything else is green color and only bracket is shown as white. Like the income tax thing, which you don't fill, but which I fill.
Okay.
Okay, these cells to be filled are white color. I can't do anything else with anybody else.
Okay.
So if I do that, okay, then that is fine.
Yeah.
It will work.
Yeah.
Yes.
Just let them check that. Income tax ka file leno. Abhi chalu hai.
And sir, except that also we can also.
Okay, done. Go. Okay. Next.